Hey guys, welcome back to another video in the Come Follow Me series. My name is Jackie Johnson and we are in week 10. And in this video, we're going to be talking about baptism. So in 2 Nephi chapters 31 through 33, he talks a lot about baptism. He refers to it as baptism by water and by fire. So I decided to make a collage of a dove that represents the Holy Ghost. And I made the background yellow and blue to represent the fire and the water. I just started out by making a lot of collage paper, by painting the papers that I wanted to use with the colors that I wanted. And then I'm just gonna rip those pieces up so that I can use them in my collage. I also drew in an outline of a dove so that I would have some guidelines of where I wanted to put my papers. I glued down my papers that make up the background first. Then I'll put my pieces down for the dove. I'm just using scrap papers and Mod Podge to lay this down, and I'm using an old paintbrush that I don't care if the bristles get ruined. Okay, so the reason for this page is, in Come Follow Me this week, we are talking a lot about baptism in these chapters. I have actually wondered about the reason why we need to have baptism. I've wondered, why can't we just follow Christ and have that be enough? What's the point? I think that these scriptures do a really good job of explaining why we need baptism. I've also been able to gain a testimony of my own for the reason why we need baptism. Jesus Christ was baptized even though he was holy. He showed us that while living on this earth, he humbled himself before the Father and witnessed that he would be obedient in keeping the commandments. During his life, he spent nearly 30 years preparing for his ministry. And then when he was ready, he entered into baptism, and that was the beginning of his ministry. In 2 Nephi chapter 31 verse 8, it says, "Wherefore, after he was baptized with water, the Holy Ghost descended upon him in the form of a dove." And then it gives us the reason why we need to be baptized. It says, "It showeth unto the children of men the straitness of the path, the narrowness of the gate by which they should enter, he having set the example before them. And the Father said, repent ye, and be baptized in the name of my beloved Son. And the voice of the Son came unto me, saying, he that is baptized in my name, to him will the Father give the Holy Ghost, like unto me. Wherefore, follow me, and do the things which ye have seen me do." So these scriptures mention a gate, and I believe that that gate represents the first step that we take down the covenant path. So these scriptures talk about a gate, and in verse 17 it says, "The gate by which ye should enter is repentance and baptism by water, and then cometh remission of your sins by fire and by the Holy Ghost." So baptism then is the first step that we take down the covenant path. And then Nephi makes sure to mention that once we have gotten on the path, that is not everything that we need to do. We're not done. He says that if we press forward with a steadfastness in Christ, having a perfect brightness of hope and a love of God and of all men, wherefore, if ye shall press forward, feasting upon the word of Christ, and endure to the end, behold, thus saith the Father, ye shall have eternal life. So the reason why we enter into baptism is so that we can witness to the Father that we will keep his commandments. We covenant to take upon us the name of Christ, stand as a witness at all times, and assist those in need. And in return, God promises the constant companionship of the Holy Ghost, a remission of our sins, and being born again. We prepare for baptism by first having faith in Jesus Christ, and then repenting of our sins. When we get baptized, we're also receiving the Holy Ghost by the laying on of hands. Why do we need the Holy Ghost as a constant companion in our lives? When we enter into our own personal ministry, we're living after the example of Christ. Everything that he did pointed others in the direction of Heavenly Father. So when we teach others about the gospel, it's really important for us to have the Holy Ghost with us. In chapter 32 of 2 Nephi it says, "Do ye not remember that I said unto you that after ye had received the Holy Ghost, ye could speak with the tongue of angels? And now, how could ye speak with the tongue of angels, save it were by the Holy Ghost? Angels speak by the power of the Holy Ghost, wherefore they speak the words of Christ. Wherefore, I said unto you, feast upon the words of Christ. For behold, the words of Christ will tell you all things what you should do." And then it says again, "For behold, again I say unto you, that if you will enter in by the way, and receive the Holy Ghost, it will show unto you all things what ye should do." So for us to be more effective in our own personal ministry, we have two things that are going to help us along the way. We need to feast upon the words of Christ, which is reading our scriptures, and we need to be guided by the Holy Ghost through revelation. So I think that it's important to understand, though, that the physical act of baptism itself isn't what washes away our sins. I believe that comes through the covenant that we enter into. I don't know how everything works, but I believe that because we are physical beings, the physical act is symbolic and it helps it to stand out in our minds. It's kind of like the same thing as if we were making a goal. If we just think in our heads, okay, yeah, you know what, I do need to be healthier. Tomorrow morning, I'm gonna wake up and I'm gonna go to the gym. If that's all the effort that we put into that commitment, that's not gonna happen. But if we made a greater commitment to that goal by doing things such as writing it down, telling someone that we really value their opinion about our goals and reporting back to them, and maybe even getting a gym buddy, it's gonna be much more likely that we're going to actually reach that goal. Ultimately, baptism and any of the covenants through the priesthood are going to bring us closer to Christ, since our greatest goal is to become more like Him and to help our brothers and sisters do the same. Covenants performed through the priesthood bring real spiritual power into our lives. I think about what my own life would be like without the covenants that I've entered into. I believe very much so that without my covenants, my commitment to following Christ wouldn't be nearly as strong. I feel like I'd be left to blow around in the wind, not having anything to tie me to Christ and His church. Covenants are actually binding. They are guideposts that lead us home. They allow spiritual power to come into our lives and help us become more effective servants. Okay, so now that I'm done with my collage, I'm gonna use these water-soluble crayons to shade around the bird just to make it kind of pop off the page a little bit more. So first I'm just laying down the color, and then I'm gonna come back in with a very slightly damp brush, and I'm going to activate the color. So that's really it for this video. If you enjoyed watching, make sure you hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell. I post a new video every single Sunday. I really enjoy talking about the Come Follow Me lessons. I also love hearing your thoughts as well. So if you had any thoughts while listening to my video or during your own Come Follow Me study, comment that down below. I always respond to every comment, and I really do love hearing what you guys think. Also, if you make an art journal page and you use my video for inspiration, I'd love to see it. If you share it on Instagram, make sure you tag me in it. A link to my Instagram is in the description box below. And use the tag CFM Art Journaling. That way I get to see your artwork, and I'd even love to share it on my own Instagram page. And if you don't already, feel free to follow me on Instagram. Thank you so much for watching this video. I love having you here. I'll see you in the next one.